Hi everyone, how are you? And thanks to the ASX for having us. So I'm Larry Diamond, co-founder of Zip and CEO. And I'll tell you a little about Zip today. We'll give a bit of a business update and then happy to pass over for any questions as well. So a little bit about Zip. We're about 6 years old. And even though we're 6 years in, it certainly feels like we are only getting started. Our purpose is the freedom to own it. And what that's all about is Zip obviously gives customers the freedom to own the moment, own the experience, own the well-being, their shoes, go on that holiday. We also own our responsibilities as a company issuing microcredit in real time, and we'll talk about that later. And also how we've architected the company. If you kind of look inside Zip, it's a very flat architecture where we empower teams to kind of run their own race and support. And it's that freedom within the boundaries that's really, I think, built our business today. And then finally, we also have a huge focus on Small Business Australia. We're giving small businesses the opportunity to offer interest-free installments at the checkout, which they've also been locked out of when compared to traditional retailers. So that's our purpose. And our mission, as you can see there, is to be the first payment choice. So Zip to be the first payment choice everywhere and every day. We're certainly on the journey. We certainly aren't there yet. We're in about 45,000 places, and we have about 1.6 million customers using us. Now, the essence of the Zip business model and why we actually love what we do is we really see it as a win-win-win. So Zip is really connecting customers with retailers or businesses or suppliers through this fair and valuable payments experience. And what that does is for customers, it allows them to enjoy interest-free terms, flexibility, a great checkout experience. If you look at our recent Amazon integration, beautiful, seamless checkout experience, and a really engaging mobile experience, really different to many other financial apps that you guys have on your phones. And the second piece is for retailers. We help them increase sales risk-free. We're driving customers back, and so we act as almost a quasi, not just a payments company, but also a marketing company. And so we really sit at the intersection of all these three, and I think that's why you've seen such awesome growth in the buy now, pay later space. And when you think about buy now, pay later, it's only been around for, say, 6 years or so in Australia, but it's very much becoming mainstream. And our view is that buy now, pay later is no longer alternative. So these alternative payments are no longer alternative. And as you can see there, 20% of all online e-commerce is now going through buy now, pay later. You're seeing one in two customers stop using their credit card and start moving onto interest-free alternatives. And what we've seen also recently is this millennial focus is actually moving into Gen X. And you can see there, one in five customers are now using BNPL that are in Gen X. So it's moved from early adoption to kind of mainstream adoption. And even though it's grown quite aggressively, our view is that it's got a long, long way to play out. As for Zip, as we mentioned, been around for about 6 years. We've been growing about 100% year on year, if you look at our key metrics over those last six years. And that's a big focus. We are a growth company, and we need to continue to invest in growth and take advantage of this awesome market opportunity. We are also a network-driven business. So once upon a time, 6 years ago, we signed up Chappelli Cycles, which is a bicycle company. They were offering hipster bikes for $600. Instead of putting that on your credit card and paying 20% interest, you could pay that off in 6 months interest-free. So we acquired our first customer, Naomi, through that bicycle retailer. Then once she joined our platform, we connected to another retailer where she could start using us. So it's very much a network effect business. As you can see there, this network is generating about $1.7 billion in annual transaction volume from 1.6 million customers, 20,000 retailers, and 45,000 places where Zip's integrated. The other big focus, which we'll touch on, is our IP decisioning. We believe we are one of the leading issuers of microcredit in real time at the checkout, utilizing a range of data sources, traditional credit, but also non-traditional credit. And we'll talk about that. Brand affinity. Unlike a credit card that sits in your pocket, which you have a very bland relationship with, we live at the checkout where you shop, online, in store. And so the connection that we build with customers, we believe, is far different to what you're going to have with your credit card sitting in your pocket. very strong gross profit margins, which as the volume comes through, will drive really strong operating leverage. And in Australia alone, we estimate more than $1 trillion of payments where we can have a conversation with, and we've just recently gone global. One of the big differentiators with Zip versus other paylaters is our strong focus on responsibility. We look at ID, we look at credit, we look at real-time bank transactional data. And our view is that not all buy now, pay later players are the same. We have focused on responsibility since inception, and that's really a core part because we believe we have a duty of responsibility issuing microcredit in real time, but we can't compromise on our standards. And so some of the stats that you see on the screen there, 1.68% in net bad debt losses, which is market leading. One in 100 Zip customers are late in any given month. Contrast that with other paylaters that are more like one in five, one in six. And the Zip credit score is higher, the average Zip credit score is higher than a big four credit card applicant. So we're getting great quality coming through, but we're utilizing enormous data at the click of a button. Now, we've been going 6 years. We did a bit of a trading update at the AGM. So up to 1.6 million customers, we've grown 77% year on year. This year, we're actually targeting 2.5 million. So again, continue that really strong growth of customer acquisition locally and also abroad in New Zealand and the UK. Merchant numbers are growing really, really strongly. And we've done $565 million for the 4 months to October. Now, since then, we've obviously had Black Friday and Cyber Monday. We won't be updating those numbers now. We'll be doing that in our quarterly in January. But suffice to say, it beat all of our internal expectations really, really strong. And what you've seen there on the right is, and I think a big, big standout is, we integrated with Amazon about 3 or 4 weeks ago. And we are Amazon's first buy now, pay later solution in Australia. It's a beautiful checkout experience. We invested a lot in the technology, and we believe that is the future of kind of checkout experiences. One click, signing up in a couple of seconds. And again, we've got a number of other retailers that have joined, like Chemist Warehouse, C-Folly, and Optus is going live in-store. The customer base, which is really interesting as well, is we still skew about 60% female, 40% male. Median age of 31, but I'm pleased to see that the males have actually had a really strong year. They've moved up the ranks. So we're seeing not just female shoppers, we're also seeing male shoppers now. Places like Bunnings are probably lifting that exposure. And in-store, which is now 30% of our volume, is also increasing significantly with the mobile experience. And for those of you that have the mobile, you can see that the barcode, it's really nice and smooth. We'll be adding QR as well next year. Our view is to be the first payment choice everywhere and every day. You can see there we're in retail, home, health, and auto. The uniqueness of the Zip product, which is more an account concept, means that we can play in any category. So we have customers using us to pay bills. We have customers using us to go into Chemist Warehouse, shop at Amazon, et cetera, et cetera. So even though we've got 47,000 places of presence, the pipeline is incredibly strong. And our view is next year you'll see Zip at more of these everyday categories as well. And the year's been a really strong year. I think if I kind of look back over the last 12 months, we've lifted our engineering workforce to about 85 engineers, not including product and data science, and that has just lifted our capability. Lifted our capability to work with partners like Amazon that require very quick checkout experiences and very high SLAs, faster response time. So we've invested a lot in the core platform to support the growth that we're seeing and the growth that we see coming ahead next year. For those that have the app, it is really a beautiful experience, and the team that we have behind the mobile is an awesome team. You can see there rated 4.8, 4.9 on the App Store. We've had about 1.2 million downloads of our apps, and you can just see it's a totally different experience to when you log into your banking app, and we see that as the engagement point with customers. Continue to invest there. And the reason we are investing is because if you look at some of these stats, they're actually quite remarkable. So we've had about 27% growth each quarter in terms of mobile engagement. But interestingly, app users, shop 3.4 times more than non-app app users. And not only are they shopping more frequently, if you look at the loss rates, they actually have lower losses. So they're more engaged. Not only are they shopping more regularly, they're also paying back much, much quicker. So it's a beautiful experience. Customers this year in 2018 are transacting 30% more than those customers that joined us last year. So they're coming into a different world. They've got Amazon, Chemist Warehouse, Kmart, Target, a beautiful native app experience. Also, 26% higher transaction frequency among our older customers. So even the older base are getting more and more active. So all of these indicators are really telling a great story for next year. We also did something a little bit different. We did our first above-the-line brand campaign, which is all about transparency, which is the core Zip model. And nothing comes between me and my. This has been very successful. It was really driven to lift unaided brand awareness. Now that we've got a huge amount of places to use Zip and lots of customers, we feel like it's important to kind of tell our story. So we'll be getting the results at the end of this month, and we're hoping it's going to tell a really good story. And finally, the Zipsters. So we were up to about 350 Zipsters in the company. Really strong culture, as I mentioned earlier. But what I'm really pleased to see is the caliber of leadership coming into Zip is what we dreamed of. So we've had Steve Brennan, who was CMO at Uber, PayPal, and eBay, just join us about eight weeks ago. We've had Patrick Collins, Chief Product Officer, who's come from Silicon Valley, and they just bring renewed energy, new energy. We've all got lots of energy, new ideas, and a lot of wonderful experience. So we're kind of lifting the caliber of capability at all levels of Zip, board, exec, and heads of, as we position to really scale this company 10x over the next few years. I think I've got a couple of minutes. I'll just jump into the next year or two. So big focus on core. If we just keep focusing on the core, which is boring, but it works, more customers transacting in more places more often, that is the formula. So let's just keep doing that and keep investing in the platform to support that growth. We've launched Installments for Business. So our view is that we've got a really strong capability in real-time credit decisioning for customers. That could be a consumer, but it can also be a small business. So we're in beta this quarter, and we'll be rolling out next year. Small businesses who have been locked out of these buy now, pay later products, we think are a great segment. They shop at all the places where Zip already offers, where Zip is already integrated, and is a very, very natural extension. We have 20,000 merchants ourselves, so it's a really great fit to kind of build that network ecosystem. And the big one, which I've actually been spending a lot of time on, I was just in the UK for a couple of weeks, is we have decided to go global. So our view is this phenomenon that we're seeing in Australia is just starting overseas, and it's important for us to be part of that story. So we bought a platform called PartPay, which has now been integrated into the Zip platform. We're now live in New Zealand. We have the largest marketplace there, the Warehouse Group. We've also just, we're in soft launch over in the UK and planning to do a proper launch at the end of next quarter. Again, we're able to transfer a lot of our relationships and technology and experiences and mobile over there. And we've got strategic interest in a company called QuadPay over in the US, which is doing fantastically well. It's, I think, even ahead of Afterpay in the shopping category of the App Store. We have a board seat there, and we've also got an interest in a company in South Africa. So I think we've kind of touched on this. For next year, we're focusing on 2.5 million customers, 2.2 billion in annual transaction volume. But if you kind of look forward over the next 3 years, we're hoping those numbers can be 5-6 million plus, and are really excited about the future ahead. That's it. I think we've got 14 seconds left, so thank you very much.